maybe set that aside to a minimum. But if I see something, I'm like, yo, you got any use for that? Set that aside, my dude.
Yeah. By the way, we have started recording. Hello, Planeswalkers. Andrew here, joined by Tyler.
God, it's been way too long, my dude.
We
It's
don't.
been way too long since we've done a Taps for Two together.
Yes, it has. I my trouble is I can rarely come up with topics for Taps for Two.
Luckily, both us and people like seeing boosties get ripped, so.
Yes, so we I have a full collector booster that we're gonna tear open tonight. So
And I'm gonna be telling Andrew, hey, save that card for me, and we're all gonna sit here and enjoy
yeah,
that.
I also got the blue white commander precon, which I've split up the cards from, that I'm gonna have a Greasefang deck that's in the works that is for me, and then the remainder is going to be a mech deck for my friend who's really into big robots.
He's very into big robots.
Also, this precon was short 16 cards, so
Yeah, that's fun.
I submitted a support ticket with wizards because that's not cool. Anyways, let's get. Oh, yeah, the music. We have the Neon Dynasty OST in no particular order. Tyler cannot hear it.
Can. So while Andrew sets everything up, let me quickly remind you that if you like what we do here, be sure to give us a sub and leave us a comment. What card are you most excited about from Neon Dynasty? There's a lot.
There is a
Like
lot.
this set is just gorgeous.
Why I got. This is my first collector box, and it's because it's got such good art.
So you've
So.
got the greatest Tanuki.
Yeah. Greater Tanuki. Wow,
The
it's a
great guest.
foil. Another foil. Okay,
Andrew, what if you just did that for the entire thing?
I'm not. So many foils.
Well, let's talk. Okay, so you got one of the sisters Yamazaki. So Andrew, you are relatively new to Magic. Like I say relatively, you've been playing for a few years.
Yes.
You are relatively new.
Yes, I didn't play card games until after I left high school.
So, do you know what is so cool about having the two Yamazaki, or I guess they're not sisters, they're cousins, having the two Yamazaki cousins?
You know. That's
Yo!
right, I should probably be holding them over here. We got Ruthless Technomancer.
Nice! Blade of
That's.
the Oni, nice!
Thundering Raiju and Biting Palm Ninja.
That artwork is upsetting.
It is. Get a good look at that, everybody. There's
But
just a
anyway,
hand coming out of there. Or sorry, a white mouth coming out of there.
do you know why it's really cool that we got the cousin Yamazaki creatures?
I don't. I assume that we had some kind of Yamazaki in a previous set.
So in original Kamigawa, I can't remember which set, but it was during original Kamigawa block, there was Brothers Yamazaki. And what they were is it was one card that had two different artworks because it was two brothers.
Yeah.
But they did the exact same thing where if they were both out on the battlefield, the legend rule didn't apply to you, and they buffed each other. But it was one card. It was just Brothers Yamazaki. And they were both legend and it was legendary. And so, here we are 1200 years later.
Their descendants are here.
Yeah. Are we just kind of going through, like, kind of passing over the commons and uncommons?
Yeah, if there's something that stands out to us, then maybe we can go over it.
The lands are gorgeous.
They are. So Mukurtai Soul Ripper, alternate art, looks like. Or no, sorry, that's the
No,
standard art, isn't
that
it?
is the classic. You don't get much more classic than that.
Yojin of Grim Betrayal.
Oh! So another cool fact about the Myojin that are in this set. So we had the original cycle of the Myojin.
Yeah.
who were also all legendary, and with them it was a divinity counter, not an indestructible counter, but anything with a divinity counter was indestructible.
Right.
They all had different effects, but they all work the same way that this new cycle does, where you remove the counter and you do a thing, and they only get the counter if you cast it from your hand. They all also have the same casting cost. Like, all these Myojin have the same casting cost as their old counterparts.
Oh, that's really cool. So, 8 mana, that's a lot.
It is, but, like, the read what the black one does that you just pulled. Like, it's nuts. Maybe read it louder so everyone can hear.
Okay. It enters with an indestructible counter if you cast it from your hand. So that's, you have to cast it from your hand. Remove an indestructible counter from Myojin of Grim Betrayal. Put onto the battlefield under your control all creature cards in all graveyards that were put there from anywhere this turn. So if you
play him and he's indestructible, and then you say, I don't know, yeah, damnation. And then you're like, hey, cool, watch this. Whoop.
So you board wipe, and then you just take everything.
Yeah!
That's so cool. So that's cool. We have Invoke Calamity.
If you don't have a use for him.
For him?
Yeah.
I have your stack of cards right here. I opened a set box during pre-release weekend for the viewers. And I've already set aside a bunch of cards for Tyler here. So we've got if I can get all these. This is the new one, and then we've got my extra Satoru Umezawa, because I got one for each box.
You're right. That artwork is gorgeous for the Dragon Kami Reborn.
It is.
Also Umezawa.
This is done by a Metal Gear artist. I know you know that, Brandon. I'm just saying. Yeah, I wasn't gonna
follow me by my first name, huh?
Sorry, Tyler. I wasn't gonna run this card, but I want it to be played, so I'm.
And I have a dragon deck.
And we have Junji.
Fable of the Mirror Breaker. It's the good artwork, too!
Yeah.
Of the Mirror Breaker!
I had one of each.
That's the good artwork.
Takanuma, the Kami War, and the Wandering Emperor. My favorite character from the story.
Really? Not your big blue thirst trap?
No, not Jin Kataxias. Jin Kataxias is cool. I like his visual design a lot. The Emperor is just so good.
She's so awesome. Invoke Calamity. It's rain and swords. Hallelujah, it's rain and swords.
Speaking of which.
Well, you know what you have to do now.
I have to run it?
You have to build dragons.
Ooh. You
probably give you a legendary 5-color dragon.
Yeah, did you say you can?
Yeah, I can give you one.
What's that?
I don't know. There's probably another 5-color legendary dragon in my dragon deck that I don't need.
Is it Scion of the Earth Dragon?
Maybe. Oh my god, that land!
It's so weird.
It's so pretty!
The foil swamp looks etched to me. Because the foiling is really muted for most of it. But where it highlights, you can really see it.
God, those are so pretty.
They're so good.
Those are gorgeous.
Izumi Blade Blesser. Jukai Trainee. Inkrise Infiltrator, Moonsnare Specialist, Rizona, Asari Commander.
A lot of... they really want to put Samurai into Boros now.
They really do. Universal Surveillance. Ah.
What's that do?
Dystopia. Improvise and draw X cards. It's an X cost.
Oh, neat.
Thousand Face Shadow.
I think that is our only reference to... Sakashima in like the whole set.
Yeah, because Thousand Face and the masks. Yeah.
Yeah.
Ogre Head Helm. This is cool.
My least favorite of the. Hey, what is that?
Do you...
Oh my god, dude! There you go.
Yeah. Okay.
There's your Grace Fang.
Yep.
Foil the good art. Like, you're running that as the commander, right?
Yes.
Like, you have to.
Yes. It's getting sleeved as we speak. There are other cards.
Oh my god, there we go. You'll love to see it.
Well, that's one of three. I just need the, Light Paws and Jingataxis now. Alexa, stop. Nobody asked you.
Andrew, please, when you post this in the title, put featuring Alexa.
Oh, that's so good.
Dude, I'm so happy for you.
God, these are so hard to open.
So, what is your favorite thing about this set, Andrew? Like, what are you most excited to really play with?
I don't know. There's so many
wonderful content, Andrew.
I mean, obviously the commanders, also Forbidden Technique.
So I didn't play original Kamigawa, but because Kamigawa was filled with so many unique legendaries, I love building with stuff from them. Like I'm almost done with Sensei Golden Tail.
They have a lot of really cool creatures. Yeah. I like
God, those lands.
I like the mechs. The mechs are really cool.
The mechs were an interesting take. I was curious if they were going to go that route. I think they did a really good job with it.
I mean, it's advanced Japan. How can you not do mechs?
Oh, did you get the alternate art of the red Cousin Yamazaki?
Looks like it.
God, she's so cool.
And March of Swirling Mist.
Nice.
Silk Guard. What is happening in that art? Is he being...
So, he's surrounded by moths.
Oh, and they're helping him by... Okay.
Well, they may not be moths. They may be, like, minor Kami. But yeah, he's yeah, getting a silk shield.
They look like moth Kami. Neat. Odawara.
Oh! Nice! That's a good one.
Atsushi?
Is it foil?
No.
Crap!
Why are you buying food at the sushi... Or why are you buying clothes at the sushi store? That's it. Eater of Virtue. I like this card a lot.
That's what they called me in high school.
Okay. Planar Incision. Like, every time I see an art that has Jingataxis on it, it's like Neuron Activation. Like, this is the one. It's not. It's not the one.
When we're done recording, we can go through and I'll see what ones you don't need and we can talk about setting those aside.
Sounds good.
All right. What do you think of the Orochi's new design? They took away the snake people's legs.
I personally don't care for it. Everything else about their design is cool. Like, I like the Orochi. I just don't really care for Naga's seven tail mentor.
They basically are just, hey, you got Master Splinter.
Another one. I have so many. Kira, Boundless
Stone. Oh. There's a leaf by Kira's face that looks like a pot leaf.
There are several that are the same.
Yeah.
Alright, what's next? Iron Soul Enforcer.
Love it. So, you don't see it on that version of the card, but it has flavor text. That's like, you break it, you buy it, you steal it, I'll find it. Or something along those lines.
Huh.
It's just so rad.
It's a samurai that uses a beat stick. Alright. Teachings of the Kirin.
Well, we might
march
have featuring...
Of Sorrow.
Yeah, I think there's a march for each color.
There is, it's a cycle. Takanuma, Abandoned Mire. Look at that art.
Is that the... Oh my god.
That's a good one.
My guy. That's gorgeous. which version of Jinkataxius is it that you're looking for?
I would like the alternate art foil, just because that whole deck's going to be foiled out. I do like the original art, and I know that the Phyrexian script only comes in the original art. So if I pulled a foil Phyrexian script, I would not complain. But I do want the alternate art more.
That, like, neon glow?
Yeah.
I love the new artwork for those for the gain lands.
This one's so funny to me, because it's a bridge, right? But yeah. it goes up yeah. real high.
Yeah, that's an actual thing in Japan.
Really?
I
see how
so
it
if you
works.
Look at it, I yeah, think, so... Yeah. I'm only getting this from secondhand knowledge, but I'm getting it from someone of Asian descent. According to them, the point of that design is to make you slow down and kind of just consider, like, think about where you are. Plus, boats can go under it.
Yeah. Springleaf Avenger.
I didn't know Kamigawa had insect people.
Yoshimaru!
You got the goodest boy!
The goodest... Hitetsugu!
It's the least exciting one, but it's Hitetsugu.
It is. Another Springleaf Avenger.
I needed to make sure that you got... What is that?
Shigeki. Jukai Visionary.
Legendary Snakeman.
Yeah. Sal Snakeman.
I'm really sad we didn't see, like, some... Like, one of the most famous cards, I think, to come out of Kamigawa, the Sakura Tribe Elder, good old Steve.
Like an updated version of that, or a new art?
Or, yeah, just some reference to him or something, but it's whatever.
Sakura Tribe Youth. Life of Toshiro Umezawa.
So, I think I've explained it before. You know what's really cool about that card, right?
Yeah, it references...
So not just Kute, right? Yeah, so the three abilities that it has that it does for chapters 1 and 2, if you want to read those out for me real quick.
Choose one, target creature gets +2/+2 until end of turn, target creature gets -1/-1 until end of turn, or you gain 2 life.
So those are the three abilities on Umezawa's Jite, which Toshiro used. Then if you flip it,
Toshiro. Pay one life, add a black. Spend his mana only to cast an instant or sorcery.
That ability was supposed to be on the Jite, and they took it off.
Because it was
so the fact it was too much, it was too powerful. So the fact that the front of the card has what the Jite does, and the back of the card, the memory, has what they wanted it to do, I think is a really nice touch.
It is really cool. I love the art for Selfless Samurai. I'll bet you can't guess why.
Andrew's a furry. Anyway.
It's not a secret. Lizard Blades.
I love that card so much. I love its alternate art because the lizards are little bearded dragons.
Yeah, it's very cute.
It's so cute.
Katsumasa.
Ooh, that's from the commander deck.
It is. Farewell.
Yep, that's a card.
It is.
It's ridiculous. What is that?
Spirit Sister's Call. Really good art.
Oh, God, that's gorgeous. That card, I love it.
Thundering Raiju. Quite pretty.
This set. It's making me nostalgic for a set that I didn't even play.
We have the best card in the set, Brute Suit.
Riot.
What's that?
Brute Suit Riot. Riot.
This card has a bit of damage on the top. Not that it really matters. You can't really see it. It's a little nick out of the corner. But
I'm super happy that we got a whole bunch of new shrine support.
Yeah, including Living Shrine.
Yeah, did you know that despite that, Shrine is not a creature type?
Yeah, it's a super type.
It's not.
It's not?
No. Oh, super types are to the left. Yeah, it's an enchantment type.
Okay, that's a really cool looking Orochi.
Which one is that?
Coiling Stalker.
Nice. Oh good, another rat.
Weaver of Harmony. It's another snake. Myojin of Towering Might.
What does that one do?
It enters with the indestructible counter. Remove the counter, distribute 8 +1/+1 counters among any number of target creatures you control. They gain trample until end of turn.
Oh!
Hey, Ryu. Storm's Edge.
The cat has decided this is... Hey, cool, another one!
And Satsuki, Living Lore.
So, I've said it to you, and I still think it's weird that they would make a legendary, like, I get for the set, because, green-white is the, and, so, the way that it's been explained that the colors work in this set is they're on a spectrum, where to the far left is technology, and to the far right is tradition. The colors fall in there, and I believe it is blue is at the far left. Blue is the one that took the most into technology, followed by red, and then black is in the middle, and then white, and then green is the most traditional. And so that's why it's enchantments versus artifacts. Yeah. Is the enchantments are meant to represent, you know, the tradition, and the artifacts are meant to represent the future, which is why the signpost uncommons for each of those is you've got that Jukai Monk, who's the green-white enchantment human monk creature who makes enchantments cheaper. And then you've got the Goblin Aeronaut, who is blue-red and makes your artifacts cheaper. So I get why the legendary that you pulled, why the Saga Commander, Saga Legendary, is green-white. I'm just sad that there's a bunch of sagas she can't use. I would have liked to see her be 5-color in some way.
Yeah, but it would have been cool if she had, like, an activated ability that was 5-color.
Yeah.
So she could still cost just a green and a white, but then have 5-color identity. But
I get why they did it. I mean, this set is not designed for Commander. It was designed for Standard.
Yeah. I mean, all of these are designed for Standard. Futurist Operative. This is fun in a Ninja deck. Futurist Operative.
And we were young.
Oh
god, put it away. Put it away. Put it away.
What's wrong?
Put it away.
What's wrong, Brandon?
Put it away!
What's wrong,
Andrew? Andrew, so help me God, I know where you live. I hate that card so much because I saved up 10,000 coins on Arena, and I went and I did my first draft, and I was super excited, and two different opponents each had drafted at least 2 copies each of Behold the Unspeakable, and then it turns into Visions of the Unspeakable, and I just got ground into dust by both people. They were both two different people playing two different decks, but they were both in blue, and they both had 2 copies out at the same time, and I hate it.
It's pretty
good. Makes me upsetty spaghetti.
Another Teachings of the Kirin. Aerial Surveyor.
That's a good one.
It's a cool one.
Want to read what it does?
Yeah. Flying. Vehicle. Whenever it attacks, if defending player controls more lands than you, search your library for a basic planes card, put it onto the battlefield, tap, and shuffle. So
we've seen this effect before in white. Where it's, oh yeah, go get a planes. But usually it puts the planes into your hand.
Yeah.
This one puts it into play.
This might be worth running in non-vehicle decks if they need more
because there's other options, there's similar ones, like I'm blanking on them right now, but there's two in particular that I'm thinking of. I think Journeyer's Kite is one of them.
Archaeomancer's Map?
No, I'm thinking they're artifact creatures that I'm thinking of. But anyway, mostly when you see that effect in white, it puts the land into your hand. The fact that this one puts it into play tapped, I think is really cool.
Yeah. Invoke Despair.
That's me when you pulled Behold the Unspeakable. Do you think you have enough copies of Teachings of the Kirin?
Matsunari Toad Rider in the meh art.
R.I.P. Kaimi.
It's good art. I don't want to knock the artist. It's good art.
And when Andrew and I used to play Yu-Gi-Oh, he played Totally Awesome. The frog in Totally Awesome looks like the frog in Katsunari's alternate art.
Here, so I have to do less editing later.
You have Totally Awesome just by you?
No. I think I have it somewhere. But this is Totally Awesome. Little toad with another toad on its back. It's very cute. Zack and Toadie. I had like an inner sleeve for the card that had Zack and Toadie written on it. Simeon Slim. Goshinpai of Ancient Wars. Yes. Modern Age. I just love these basic lands.
They are so pretty.
They're so good. I want to see more, like, full art basics, which they've done more of in recent memory, but
yeah,
I want them to keep them coming. They're so good. Thousand Face Shadow. Normal. Kameinu Battle Armor. Seems like very uncomfortable battle. Look, that dude in the art is probably just looking at it like, how am I supposed to wear this?
Go ahead, Andrew. Finish your statement. Call.
No.
Oh, good. Two copies of the same mythic.
Rasona. Sorry, Commander.
Is that Jezreel?
Yes! The exact one that I needed.
Oil and the... Alright, so that's 2 of 3, my dude.
It's like an $80 card. Oh my god.
You got there.
Okay.
You love to see it.
I'm kind of feeling like this box was worth it. You know? $80 card. The rest of the cards, which is what? Like, I don't know. 11 times 15 cards just needs to add up to 220, and then this box was worth it. I have the box for Gengataxius Progress Tyrant right here. I don't have Gengataxius yet, but this.
Hey, we're not done.
I know. I just want to show this. It's going to be foiled out. I even took my Blightsteel Colossus that I had in another deck that is also real. To put into this deck. It's not...
Like that you have to clarify that your cards are real.
Yeah, because most of my cards are proxies, because I'm not made of money, but I have a problem with making decks. But
I'm not made of money, said the man who's opening up a collector's booster box.
This is true. Another cool thing with this deck is it's going to have metal tokens, or it has them. There's an Etsy store that does these. They're like $5 a piece. Really cool. So that's where the Tezzeret's going. I'm very excited. It's also a 3D printed box, also on Etsy. I think I made a tweet about it when I got them. Yep.
Cat is screaming for attention.
It's pretty quiet screaming. This is maybe my favorite art in the set.
When is it?
Discover the Impossible.
Oh yeah, that's a good one.
I got the art card in the set box last weekend, and it's I'm making a resin table that's gonna be filled with it's gonna be covered in magic cards, mostly art cards, and Discover the Impossible is one of the art cards, and it's going. I might want to make a video showing it off once it's done, assuming I don't mess it up. Because I've never worked with resin before. A Gonjo Uprising. Big old battle happening in the art. Organic Extinction.
Gave Royce some treats, so hopefully he'll be quiet for the rest of this.
Nice. Ishii.
It's over, Anakin! I have the two heavens!
Line.
Just look at him and tell me that that artwork in particular does not look like Obi-Wan Kenobi.
It does kind of look like Ewan McGregor? What's his name?
Ewan McGregor?
Ewan McGregor, yes. I was like, there's not that many M's. Lion Sash. Ah.
Alright there, buddy?
No, I'm not. March of Burgeoning Life.
It's the last pack.
We've had some good.
I mean, even
games.
If you don't get, even if you don't get Jingataxi, it's like you got two of the three.
I got
66% is a D, which is still technically passing.
I got two of the four. I still need Light Paws, but
oh, never mind.
But I think Tezzeret was the second largest next to Jingataxius. I don't think Grease Fang is worth too much. I don't think Light Paws is either. But I know Tezzeret's like 80, Jingataxius is a little more than that. At least the one that I want. Okay, Agonjo, Seat of the Empire. Rampant Rejuvenator, it's a Hydra.
It's a plant Hydra.
It is. That's pretty neat. Reckoner Bankbuster. It's another mech.
I love the alternate art for that, just because it's got the... There you go.
Yeah, good art.
Totally awesome. It's a shame that in the story, that guy's an actual piece of garbage.
Cloud Steel Kid.
Oh no. Great. I can't wait to play against... Can't wait to play against Sir Gwyn.
Sir Gwyn with You Can't Lose the Game. If your opponents can't win the game, yeah. It's happening. So all in all, not bad. I got a couple of cards I'm excited about. That
nice. That this I can't wait for my box to get here. I didn't do a collector box like you did, but
yeah, it's like I can only justify doing this like very rarely, but last year it was Forgotten Realms that I got a lot of boxes of. It just has to be a set that excites me enough for me to budget out a so much sealed.
It's such a good set, though.
It really is. Such good art, really cool cards. For everyone watching, I do advise you to buy singles. It's just more economic. You'll save more money. But if you have the disposable income, crack away. It's very fun.
Yeah. Buy the packs, crack the cards, then send them to me.
Yeah, this has been a lot of fun. This is just a good time. Just opening packs.
So, what's your favorite card that you opened?
The Tezzeret. I'm gonna look at it again. That's the wrong box. It's in this box. Why do they take the worst character? Like, I hate Tezzeret. I hate him. But then they just told someone, like, hey, take this villain and make him as hot as possible. And that's what they did.
Deseret out here being the origin of the G-Nashi, why do you get to lose two moms?
That's so messed up.
Because Deseret is the reason behind Nashi losing both his birth mom and Tamio.
Yeah. I ended up trading away the... I opened a Tamio completed Sage, and I traded it away a few days ago. I didn't have a use for it. But I traded it for cards that I will have a use for. Oh, I want to look at... She is here.
I love that artwork so much.
It's so good. Like
good old biker mice from Kamigawa.
Like, the original artwork has grown on me, but it still doesn't hold a candle to the alternate art.
I love that the normal art, it's like, we are tough, scary rat people. Like, we pride ourselves on being outcasts, and this is what we do. And then the anime artwork is like, hi, we're from the 80s.
Yeah, she looks like she's from an 80s cartoon.
Like, look at her hair!
Yeah. She looks good for it.
Yeah, no. I think you got some sick pulls.
Yeah. Some good stuff. Now to trade for Jin Gataxius and Light Paws. And then I'll be satisfied.
Remember, however good you think Light Paws is, she is 10 times better than that.
Yeah, apparently she's just busted.
She is bonkers.
Tyler's been playing her in Arena, in Historic
Bar. Hey, I was on a losing streak, and I decided I just wanted to win some games, and so I brewed Light Paws in 5 minutes, and subsequently went to go on and do that.
It really is that simple. You play enchantment, you get other... Or you play aura, you get more aura. Aura. That's the name of the deck. That's the name of my deck. That when I build it, aura. Yes, I did it.
I call mine all auras all the time.
Nice. All right, I'm gonna wrap up this. Oh, one more thing I want to show off because I'm happy with it. I drew tokens, lots of tokens. I had much fun with them. Woof. Goblin. Treasure. Illusion.
Dun, 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 dun.
And then some of them I just kind of gave up on. I'm not an artist, but I had fun. I had fun drawing these.
That's all that matters. What the hell is that?
This?
Yeah.
It's an insect.
Oh, insect. Does that think? Oh my god. Stick fuck. I hate you.
Octopus?
Yeah, that's just a regular octopus.
Short.
Oh, I'm sorry. That doesn't look like an octopus. That's just a man.
Yeah. Kraken. Coma's coil. Yeah, there's frog lizard.
Oh, it's Randall.
It's Randall Kermit. Really good ones.
Is that a clue?
That is a clue. yeah, some of these aren't as good as others. That one's kind of good. Blood token.
What is that?
It's a blood vial from what's it called? Code Vein.
I don't know what that is.
It's an extremely anime Bandai Namco game.
Ah.
Where you play as vampires, but not. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. Like, comment, and subscribe. It helps us out a lot. And, as always, have a great day.
Later!